this whole country. I would say my jina, alafu wase wa like, who's that? By the time you say, ukisha sema hii jina, wase wa washasikia. And so I'll tell you her say, her name that she's known by, and also her real name. Her name is Joanne Munyi, but we know her, and every Kenyan knows her as Yummy Mummy. Tell me you've not heard that name. Na kama ujaisikia, I know you'll be like, ah, hiyo nimesikia, but I'm not sure where or what it's about. Yummy Mummy is here with us today. You're going to meet her in a second. She's a content creator. She's a mother. She's a wife. She's a body positivist, and she will explain exactly what that is a little bit later. And most importantly, okay, same as, you know, being a content creator, she's a vlogger. Khalifa Salmia wase.
Kwanza umenitoa kwa point. Yeah. Umesema wadi ingine imeni discourage. Ooh. She's a wife.
Oh.
Hapo hapo nimejitoa. Nishavujika.
Anyway,
social media. Na ndio tumeanza kama kawaida, tuko na guest DJ pia, usisahau usitoke. Yami niko na some questions.
So let's go right ahead and meet our guest, Yummy Mummy, also known as Joanne Munyi.
Hi.
Karibu sana.
Thank you for having me.
I'm so happy to have you.
Thank you.
Yes.
Are you Khalifa? Nilipatikana 3 years ago.
Hey, you imesimentiwa 3 years. That one is ish. That one has a stamp on it, manze. Hakuna kuingilia huko.
Nimeshajitoa. Sawa, inakubalika. Aliangukia. Jamani
aliangukia.
Thank you. I'm making our guests blush, Maze. Oh, but you are a wonderful lady.
Thank you.
Maze. You vlog, you're a content creator, which backstage you're telling me that's the same thing. I was like, yeah.
It's like a fancy word.
It's a fancy word.
Like you have a real job. You know what I'm saying?
And then on top of that, Maze, you're a mom, which is never easy work. You're a wife, which is not easy work either. And you mentioned to me that you're a body positivist.
Yes.
Am I saying it correct?
You're saying it correct, yes.
So what is a body positivist?
Just like that. You don't have to be constantly trying to put on weight or to lose weight or to change your hair or to wear a specific type of clothes. I just feel like everybody should just be beautiful in their own way. And that's basically what a body positivist is.
So
it's
being,
a movement.
Being positive about your body, basically.
Yeah, it's like, this is the way God made me.
So if you're thin, be positive.
Yeah, exactly.
If you're not thin, be positive.
Exactly, just be the way that you are, because God made you the way that you are. And God didn't make mistakes.
That's true. That is true. And by the way, complaining, my mom used to tell me when I was young, when you complain about your outside appearance or how you are as a person, you're basically telling God what you did is not good enough.
Exactly.
Like the work you did,
God, and
and it does, apparently, it used to hurt God's feelings, and so I took that seriously.
What?
And that's what made me become so body positivist without even knowing I'm like, body positivist.
Oh God, that's a nice, I think I'm going to adopt that for my kids.
Yeah.
Because I don't hurt God's feelings.
Yeah.
Just love yourself.
Okay, that thing used to tear me apart. Like, I don't want to hurt God's feelings. But yeah, it's a good one.
Big up to your mom.
You are a mom as well.
Exactly. Yes,
may I please ask, I hope it's not a personal question, how many children you have?
I have 2 children.
Okay.
I have Ethan, who's 8 years old.
Yes.
And then I have a daughter, Mukeni, who is 1 year old.
Ah,
yeah.
Okay.
But
they still get along.
Exactly. They still get along. They love each other so much.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Our producers have pulled up your Instagram page, so I want us to go and look at that. And so, why, Maze? Geez, 50,000 followers.
Imagine.
So and then following 703. At Yaujui Pali Wametoka. Oh my gosh. Oh, your bio says millennial mom, wife, human, body positive, fearlessly influencing, Maze. Wow.
Yeah.
So, as we continue to scroll down, let's continue to talk. I like how you've put there human.
Yeah.
Because, you know, people can look at you and be like, oh my gosh, you're fearlessly influencing, which is true. Mm-hmm. You're there, you're confident with your body, someone is there, akona uzuni about
it's
their
true,
body.
Yes.
And so someone might, and then you're a mom, you're a wife, you're doing all this stuff, guys know you, you've got your life, you've got your head on straight.
Mm-hmm.
And so guys are looking at you thinking, how did all this begin? When did it begin? And how was it in the beginning?
So I only became a content creator last year, actually. I started actively influencing, actually, I think it was around August last year. So I've always had an Instagram page, I think for the past 3 or 4 years, but I wasn't like as serious, like now I'm actually posting, creating content to post on Instagram.
Right.
But I realized that the more that I posted about my life, the more that I posted, you know, experiences that I was going through, a lot to do with like being a mom, being a wife, being just a woman, like the things that anyone as a woman goes through, whether it's things to do with hygiene, things to do with hair or makeup or,
anything.
You know, clothes, whatever it is, like just the struggles that anyone has.
Yes.
The more I posted, I realized a lot of women now started following me. And it's like my audience is about about 75% women, 25% men. Okay. So I realized that many people were following me and like relating with the things that I was talking about.
Yes.
So around August last year is when I was like, okay, so I think this can be a thing that I could actually actively pursue, because I realized that a lot of people seem to have interest in it and it's something that I loved to do.
Mm.
So August last year is when I actually started my YouTube channel, which now is at 25,000, almost at 25,000, which is really exciting.
Oh my gosh, congrats.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
And yeah, and that's when I actively started now, you know, like doing shoots to post on my Instagram and like, you know, actively trying to see what kind of content do people want to see from me, what topics do people want to hear me talk about, and that's when I actually started doing it. So I would say it's been about, from August, how many months is that? September, October, November, December, January, February, March, April, 8 months.
About nine, yeah, about eight
yeah,
months.
Exactly.
Oh my goodness. So that's not a long time.
It's not a long time, it's a very short time. Yeah.
Yeah, I would have thought you've done this for like 4 or 5 years.
No, for imagine, the kind not of, yet even a year.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Wow. And so, you know, you've talked about your content and that's what made people reach out to you, made people love you, made people connect to you.
Yeah.
And so your content is actually not just one particular, you know, sometimes when vloggers decide to venture out on content creating, they start to write about, okay, me, I'm a makeup person, or all right, I'm writing about moms, all right, I'm writing about clothes, or you know, fashion.
Yeah,
so but you're all okay, I can't say all over the place, but you are jack of all trades.
Yeah,
so you've done motherhood, like you said, then you're doing a little bit of outside appearances like hair and stuff like that, clothing.
Yeah,
and you've also touched on your interests, you're a biker,
and
there's a photo that we passed, and that's why I was trying to pause my producer. I was trying to pause my producer, but if we could go back up, I saw you in a photo that you had posed with a whole bunch of bikers.
Yeah.
Where were you guys
at? Last weekend, I mean, a part of a sisterhood of biker chicks.
You're only female.
Yes, we're only females.
Oh,
we're called the Ink Sisterhood. Love those girls.
What?
So we do rides every so often, and this last weekend went to Loy Tok Tok.
Okay.
So it was really, really, really fun. Yeah,
oh
I love biking. I only started that in December, because my husband was a biker. He introduced me to it, and now I just love it so much.
I love your life, man.
I know. I love your life too.
What? No, because you know, most of the time I look at bikers who are ladies, and I'm just like, you guys have guts. Because sometimes you're driving in traffic, and you see so many bikes, you're like, nyinyo. Then you see the occasional
you
see like a nice weave, and I'm like, oh my gosh, you go, girl! Yes, and she's not scared, she's there weaving through the traffic, fearless. But it takes some guts.
It does.
You're living your truth, you're living you.
Yeah.
What made you wake up and decide, I need to vlog about certain things? Because even though you do vlog a lot about different aspects of life, it does take a point in time where you make that active decision.
Yeah.
What drove you to that active decision?
Honestly, I don't even think that it was an active decision for me. Because like when I started my channel, and I'm always asked, like, not really my channel, but my Instagram page, it's not like I didn't start out to be an influencer. I didn't start out to be a content creator. Me, I was just posting. This way you go online, just post.
Yeah.
And I love to talk. I'm an open communicator. My husband can tell you. My mother, my sisters cannot tell you that I talk a lot. So for me, it was like an outlet that I could just share things that I was thinking about.
Yeah.
And when I posted, I found that there were many women who would write back and be like, oh yeah, even me. Oh yeah, even me. When I'm talking about something like, even something as mundane as like period pains, you know, or talking about being in Tao and then someone splashes on your water, like random things. And I found that the more I posted, the more I shared my life, the more other people were also being able to share with me. And I loved that kind of like give and take, that kind of engagement.
Of course.
And then over time I just realized like people, my followership was just increasing, because at some point last year, I think in like June, I must have been at like, I don't know, maybe 9,000. And then I just noticed that people were just following me. And I was like, the more I post, the more I talk, people just seem to be following me. So I was just like,
Munachafta nini. And you're just posting on Instagram.
Yeah, I was just posting on Instagram. That's when I hadn't even started my YouTube channel. And I just realized people were following me. And so when they started following me, and people would now tell me, oh, please talk more about motherhood. Or please talk about, you know, your hair. Or please talk about this. Then now I would start talking about the things that people actually want to listen to. And then I realized now the more that I did that, the more that people followed me. So for me, it's like, I don't know, I feel like I chose, like I actively decided to become an influencer. I feel like it just
kind of happened.
Exactly, it just kind of happened.
Yeah.
And then now I'm here, and I thank God, because I love it so much.
Yeah.
But I feel like, I guess it's one of those things that it just, it's like if it's your path,
it's your path.
You find it in one way or another.
I'm glad you brought that up, because I also believe if your path, it's your path. If it's
absolutely
your time, it's your time. If it's for you, it will just, like the way you said, you don't even have to look for followers, it'll just come.
Exactly.
So in my mind, I think, Miss Munye, this is exactly what you're meant to be doing in this life.
Yes.
Yeah. Something that comes to you that way just means this is your portion.
And you don't have to force it. You don't have to, you know, like, try so hard. Because for me, honestly, I post so many pictures on Instagram. I post so many Insta stories that people are like, where do you even find the time to do it? And I'm like, yeah, it doesn't even take, like, honestly, I can do it in my sleep. Putting up Insta stories, I can do them in my sleep. Even editing YouTube videos, putting up YouTube videos, it's so easy for me. It comes so naturally to me that it never feels like work. It just feels like life.
Doing stuff.
Exactly. It just feels like life to me.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
And you know, you talked about sharing,
yeah,
and that's the reason why people reach out to you. Mm. I have to ask you, do you, because there has been a little bit of buzz that, oh my gosh, you know, I feel like Yummy Mommy might be sharing too much sometimes. Sometimes the stuff that she says is a bit too personal. I feel like she needs to draw a line here.
Yeah.
How do you feel about such comments? And do you consider yourself as an oversharer?
That's an interesting question. Yesterday I posted a picture which said that if I got $1 for every time somebody shared an opinion about me oversharing, or about me sharing something, or about an opinion that I had, I would be so rich.
Yeah.
I would be so rich. Mm. But the thing is, you know what? We all grew up in different backgrounds. Yeah. We all grew up believing different things. Our boundaries are all different.
That's
so
true.
My boundaries might not be the same as your boundaries.
That's true.
There are some people who, even when I post a picture of talking about pads or something like that, the guys will be like, what, don't talk about that. But for me, I'm like, why? This is something that all women experience, that all women go through, so why is it an issue, you know? And for me, I always feel like my life, God has given me the experiences that I've had, the challenges I've had, the knowledge that I have, so that I can be a blessing to other people.
That's
I am
true.
Blessed so that I can be a blessing.
That's
and for
true.
Me, if I don't share, I'm being selfish, you know? Especially this, a lot of things I share about single motherhood, because before I got married to my husband, I was a single mother. So there's a lot I share about, like, single motherhood, about being in a blended family, about the challenges of motherhood. And the interesting thing is, whenever I share these things, there's always women out there who reach out to me and say, oh, I thought I was alone in this struggle. I thought that I'm the only one who goes through this. And the reason they feel alone is because no one ever talks about those things.
Yeah.
So everyone is just in their own little cocoon, suffering, thinking they're alone, but actually we are all of us, you know, struggling. And for me, that's the reason I do it, for to let that one person today know that it's not just you who's going through this, or there are other people around you, you know. And that one thing is what could cause that person not to give up, or not to, you know, go down a dangerous path. And for me, that's really why I do it. It's like, overall, what am I trying to achieve? I'm trying to encourage someone. I'm trying to inspire somebody. I'm trying to empower somebody.
You don't let someone know that you're not alone.
Exactly.
Yeah. As much as everyone else is quiet,
I'll let you know that I'm there. And you see, for me, I love the engagement that I get. People will tell you, my followers, no matter how many followers I have, I do my best to respond to all DMs that I get.
Wow.
As much as I can. Like, there are hundreds in a day. So
and you run your own social media,
yes,
right? You don't have someone DMing for you.
It's just me. It's just me.
It's so a personal thing.
It's a very personal thing. Because for me, with every single, even though there are 50,000, those are, for me, they're like online friends. For me, they are all my friends, you know. Where anytime someone DMs me with a problem, I'll be like, this is like my friend, this is like my sister reaching out to me, you know. So I do my best to engage with all of them. And for me, if my oversharing is what causes somebody to be encouraged or inspired, I'm an oversharer.
Yeah, you just go ahead and overshare.
Go ahead and do it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I love you.
Mm-hmm.
What? So now I have to ask.
Yeah.
Oversharing and people coming their own opinions.
Yeah.
You have mentioned that you don't mind, or you don't tend to listen about opinions.
Mm-hmm.
But our young people out there are building their lives online as well.
Yeah.
And a lot of the times, they might not have thick skin like you do.
Yeah.
And so they encounter what we call internet bullying, cyber bullying, all that kind of stuff. And they don't have that confidence or that esteem to take it the way you take it. And I'd just like for you to talk a little bit on that when it comes to internet bullying, how it's been for you, and how maybe our youth can handle.
It's tough. Honestly, I can't even lie, it's tough. When I first started my channel, when my followership was really low, or not really low, but like at 9,000, 10,000, it wasn't as much.
Yeah.
It actually wasn't even there at all. People were like, everyone who followed me was just like, there was a lot of positive vibes. But I realized the more that I grew, and the higher my audience grew, the more the hate seemed to be there. Because now suddenly it's like, okay, who is this person? And then suddenly everyone has an opinion. You post a video, it's like, what, did you see what she posted? You post a picture, it's like, oh my gosh, she's exposing too much. Oh my gosh, did you see what she said? Oh my gosh. Like, literally, so many people have so many different opinions. But you know what?
Yeah.
I thank God for my thick skin. Initially, it would really, really affect me, but I thank God for my husband. He really keeps me grounded. Sometimes when someone says a really negative comment, there are people who say some really horrible things. There are people who come and say, you're a horrible wife and mother. You're so fat and ugly. You should never post a picture. I mean, sometimes it's like, I even wonder.
Sometimes you even ask yourself, like, you removed yourself from bed to be negative.
To come actually online to now post a comment like this. And for me, I ask myself, I tell myself, for somebody to actually in their house be hating somebody who they don't know, that says a lot about them. Like, you don't know me. Yeah. You don't know who
You've never had a conversation with me.
You've never met me. It's just this video that you've seen, and now you feel like you have the right to give an opinion about me, you know?
Of course.
And for me, just what I tell myself is, I actually just tell myself, let me say a prayer. I say a one sentence prayer for that person. I just say, God help that person, because they must be a very sad person. Mm. And honestly, for content creators out there, or for the youth who are trying to like get into this space, I'm like, you just have to have a thick skin, because I mean, what is there to do? Because these people will never stop. They'll never stop. Some people just do it for fun. Some people do it because they genuinely, maybe they just don't understand your content. Right, and the thing is, when you become a content creator, not everyone will like your content.
That's
which
true.
Is normal.
That's, yeah, you know, exactly. It's expected.
And that someone not liking your content doesn't mean that you have bad content. It just means it's not for you.
For them.
Exactly.
It's not their cup of tea.
Exactly. So I'm like, if someone comes to my page and they don't like my page, I just always tell them, just unfollow, because there are 50,000 other people who like my content and they'll stay, but you don't have to stay.
Right.
Yeah. So if someone just has to develop a thick skin and just say, you know what, me, I'ma just do me. Mm, me, just block and delete somebody or just ignore them.
Move on with life.
Bye. Yeah. See you. Bye. And that's it.
Yeah. And life goes on.
And life goes on. Yeah.
All right. Well, our producers are giving us a game to play because, you know, Social Friday, we need to loosen up a little bit.
Okay.
And as they're doing that, as we wait, let's continue to just talk a little bit. Maybe our last question.
Yeah.
When it comes to, generating income on social media.
Yeah.
You know, this being a youth channel, I always say this. I've never, ever advocated. Yes, it's fine to go and get a desk job. It's fine to go and sit from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. That's perfectly fine.
Mm.
But let's say that you don't get that opportunity. Let's say that you search for that for like 4, 5, 6 years. Because that happens to people in Kenya.
Yeah.
When that happens, you might need to fall back on a business idea. And you think to yourself, maybe do social media.
Yeah.
How is it when it comes to income generating?
Well, the first thing that I would say is a lot of people reach out to me on social media and they say, oh, me, I want to be an influencer. How do I do it? How can I start? When can I start earning money? And the first thing that I would say is that, first of all, it's not that easy. It's not like you just open your YouTube channel today, then now you're earning money, or you just open your Instagram and then now you're earning money. Other people's jobs always look a lot easier when you're not doing that other person's job.
Yeah,
even
true.
When you look at what you can be like, hey, your cousin is racy, but let me tell you, there's no one's job
which is easy.
Mm. So even on social media, it's the same. It requires work, it requires energy, it requires time and resources. When you start your channel, you have to be consistent, you have to be persistent, you have to create good quality content. You have to talk about things people actually care about. You have to be interesting enough for people to actually come and watch you.
Wow.
And you have to take time to build your audience.
Mm.
You don't just start. Because, I mean, it's not just about the numbers that you have on social media. There are people who even have, like, 10K, but those people are influencers. And there are people who have 200K, and those people are not influencers.
Mm.
Because you have to take time to build an audience who actually listens to you, who actually engages with you, so that you're able to actually translate value to the brands that you work with.
Right.
So you need to take the time to actually build that audience. And that comes with time. Like, it's, I mean, some people grow relatively fast. Like, I've grown relatively fast. Some people take years and years and years to grow, but you have to take the time to do it right. You can't just start today, then now today you want to earn money.
Mm.
It doesn't work like that. But eventually, when you do grow, you have to keep being consistent. You have to be able to reach out to brands who you feel are consistent with the messaging that your brand is on.
Yeah.
So like for me, for example, I work with a lot of like food companies because I love food and I'm always talking about food. I work with a lot of like travel companies because I like to travel. I work with like motherhood, marriage, family, lifestyle kind of oriented brands. It would be strange for me to now start working with a photography brand or something like that, because I don't
because you don't do photography
exactly. Unless photographs are being taken of me, because I really like photographs being taken of me.
Yeah, I could see that up there.
Exactly. No, but anyway, my point is that you need to do things which are in line with what you are actually talking about on your social media channel. Luckily, I talk about so many different things, and that's just because when I started my YouTube channel, I was like, I'm a woman. There's so many facets to women. Like, I can't
can't just be a mom.
You can't just be a mom. And then all the things you want to talk about, I want to talk about the fight I had with my husband. Now,
what's so now I have to be a wife.
Exactly. You know. So for me, I found a way to be able to incorporate them all. But I'll just tell somebody who wants to get into this space: take time, do your research online.
Yeah.
You know, to see what your space, the space is like on YouTube, mm-hmm. get a lot of information from the internet, from other people who are doing it, mm-hmm. and then build your brand, be consistent, and over time the money will flow. But see, kazi yati ya leo, alafu
ya leo, leo.
Pata pesa. It's not like that.
Mm. Oh my gosh, you know, this is just amazing, because sometimes people think, okay, you've grown relatively quickly, yeah. just as yeah. you said, and they'd be mm. like, yeah, my mommy has been online for only 1 year, now she's doing well, so even
yeah,
me, I can.
So, yeah.
So now guys will be like, yeah, even me by next year. Mm.
Exactly. Mm. Not necessarily. You'll find some content creators can tell you that they've been online for 5 years mm. and now is when they start earning money. Some people have been online for 10 years and now is when they start earning money. The trajectory is very different for different people, depending on your niche, depending on the kind of how differentiated your content is.
Mm.
So if that is not the case, I mean, if yours is very similar to what's already there, it will take time for you to get to where you want to be.
Hiya, sawa. Mm-hmm. You guys have heard some advice from Yummy Mommy, and right mm-hmm. now we need to loosen the show up kidogo.
Uh-huh.
And as much as you guys have heard this good advice, we need to now get into some games. Is that okay?
Yes.
So let's do that. Social Friday, this is what we're about. And okay. so our mm-hmm. This is what the rules are. If you were an or a, what would be your name? All right, so that's the rule of the game.
Okay.
I'm guessing it's a pretty simple game. And I'm seeing the first one there is written Instagram Slay Queen.
So, Instagram Slay
yeah,
Queen.
What would be your name?
I think Yummy Mommy still
it's a good one.
Sounds really good for an Instagram Slay Queen.
It does.
Think about it, it could be translated in a very slutty way.
Yeah.
So,
that's
yeah,
so true.
I think it would still be Yummy Mommy. Mm. Yeah.
Mm. And someone who didn't know your work, they'd be like, Yummy Mommy.
Exactly. You
what
know,
is
just
Yummy
like,
Mommy?
Mm, it's almost like MILF.
Yeah, so true. Uh-huh. Hiya. So, if you could be a DJ, what would be your name?
Oh my gosh. Probably something to do with my hair. So that uh-huh. as I'm spinning, I'm just like.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe DJ Locks.
DJ Locks.
DJ Locks.
DJ
Locks. DJ Locks Ako.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
What do you mean?
What's
it called?
What are the
DJ Yami.
Oh yeah. Okay.
DJ
yeah.
Yami Iko.
No.
Ah,
I guess
yeah,
I would
kuna.
Be DJ Yami.
DJ Yami.
Mm, like you can't use Yami Mami for every
you know that
answer.
Tag, like, it's just so mean. I don't know what let's see, DJ
Yami.
Exactly. I don't know. I'm a DJ Curves, so I'm gonna my curves.
You are curvy. Mm. Ah, DJ Curves. That's
yeah.
a good one.
Okay, call
uh-huh.
DJ Curves.
All right, if you're a rapper.
A rapper.
I don't want to hear Yummy Mommy.
Oh my God. Okay, okay.
I'm a little Yummy, I'm a little Mommy.
Oh, that's a good
no,
one.
None of those.
Are you sure?
Yeah, you can't use those.
Oh man. But you see, now I have to think about things which are uniquely me, which is mm-hmm. usually my hair or my body mm-hmm. or.
It could be something your personality too.
My personality.
Mm. You're hella confident.
Did you? Okay, so confident. No. What are rappers called? Miss something. Ooh, okay. Miss Babes.
Miss Babes. You sound like a failed Kenyan rapper.
Like a failed Kenyan rapper.
Yeah, Miss Babes. Miss Babes.
Oh my gosh.
Miss yeah, I mean, Plus. Miss Babes.
Oh, Miss Plus. I'll call myself Miss Plus because I'm plus
Miss
size.
Plus. Oh. Okay, that's not bad.
It's not bad.
Are you plus? You're not plus size.
I
you're just curvy.
I'm plus size. Proudly plus size. Yeah.
You look great,
I
darling.
Mean plus.
Higher, mm-hmm. higher. WWE wrestler.
Oh my gosh, you guys.
Something badass.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God.
Some enjoy champions.
Biker bitch.
That's a good one.
Mm.
That's a good
like
one.
Her.
You see?
And I'm going to knock you out.
And you just a second ago, you're complaining. I see you guys.
I know.
That's a good one. Biker bitch.
I might have a future as a WWE wrestler.
You know?
Yeah.
Ah, by the way.
Yeah.
Can we have the next one?
I'll practice with my husband.
This
oh,
is the last
God.
One. This now, Yummy Mommy. And you cannot use Yummy Mommy, Sidri Watch as the name I have refused. So please, I want you to think properly. It's the last one. You don't have to be a stripper to be a pole dancer. You could just be pole dancing in your...
No, I'm not a stripper kind of pole dancer. If I want to do it, I
could be dancing on a pole in your room.
I want to go all the way.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
Wait first.
Chafua bus. Chafua.
Something, I want it to be like something to do with like being a taking care of... Okay, I've got it.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Are you guys ready?
The Naked Nanny.
Ooh.
Because I'll take care of you like you're my baby.
The naked
baby,
nanny.
And I'm naked.
You're crazy.
I'm the naked the Naked Nanny.
Yes. The Naked Nanny. Oh, that's a good one. Hey, shock on you, someone who's watching there is starting a company.
You know Naked
starting
Nanny.
A company.
And
he has been.
Register.
I love that one. Naked Nanny. But let's remember, you guys, keep in mind that the lady we have on stage with us is not called Naked Nanny. She's name is Yummy Mommy. She's a mom and she's a wife and she's a content creator, and we've had so much fun having her on set. Cindy.
Yes, tell people to follow me.
By the way, yes. And I wanted to give you a chance, please. If you want to do any shout outs, you can, maybe to your kids if they're listening, or if
my kids know if you're listening.
I know.
Shout out to my husband, love you, babe.
There you go. And then your social media handles.
Please follow me on Instagram at yummymommy.ke, on Twitter at yummymommyke, and on YouTube yummymommyke.
Yes. I'm a Shikayo. Exactly. And you guys remember, please, if you want to reach out and say anything about what we've been discussing today, you can do that on social media pages. As I said earlier, that is Y254 channel on all social media platforms. On YouTube, if you want to watch Yummy Mommy again and learn some of the ideas that she said and put them into practice, you can do so on our YouTube page. Please do subscribe. That will be on Y254 channel. My name is Joy Mochache, and I'm on Joy_Mochache. Keep watching. Barry Moses is coming through with the next interview.